Batman, the Brave and the Bold. The episode The Mask of Matches Maloney was banned in the US for an innuendo Latin song sung by the Birds of Prey. The episode eventually did air in the US, with part of the sequence removed. Like Black Canary wiggling her finger while singing about Aquaman's little fish. Kirby, right back at ya. Shellshock was an episode of the Kirby Right Back anime series. The episode was supposed to air on June 11th, 2005, but was preempted by this week's baseball. The episode did not properly air until 2006. The English dub of the episode has not resurfaced since. However, the Japanese version is still available on YouTube. As of now, the only thing that remains of the English dubbed version of this episode is the commercial for it. Batman, the Animated Series, Episode 0. Batman, the Animated Series had a short pitch reel titled The Dark Knight's First Night that was presented to Fox before production of the series formally began. It was never broadcast and left unseen for 12 years until it was released on DVD as a bonus feature. Unfortunately, the original audio track was lost and was dubbed over by the main theme of the series. Time Squad. After Time Squad was cancelled in early 2002, a few episodes were held back or misplaced from the Cartoon Network lineup for unknown reasons. The series finale was presumably Nobel Peace Surprise in the summer of 2002, with 5 more episodes seemingly stuck in limbo until the spring of 2003. The real finale was an episode called Orphan Substitute, and it did not air until November 2003. Due to the unfounded fear that the viewers would complain about the show's mocking of the US president at the time, George W. Bush. These extra episodes were most likely aired due to Cartoon Network wanting to get rid of the series as fast as possible. Though the episode is hard to come by, it can still be found online. Toon News. In 2004/2005, Disney created a CGI series called Toon News that would be aired on Toon Disney. The show featured a robot cowboy called Smokey Silvers, who would pilot a news blimp over Toontown while delivering the news. It ran for 26 5-minute long episodes, all of which had become scarce and really hard to find. The Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy. In 1996, while Maxwell Adams was still in college, he created a short animated film titled Billy and Mandy, which would later evolve into Cartoon Network's hit show The Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy. The character designs in the short film were quite different from the actual show, with Billy appearing taller and with a smaller nose, and Mandy sporting pigtails, a nose that she lacked in the series, and a black jumper with overalls. In an interview with Maxwell Adams, he mentions that he has stored the short film away, even hinting that he should have it digitally transferred at some point. Ned's Declassified High School Survival Guide. Exactly a year after Ned's Declassified had ended, Devin Werkheiser had signed onto a development contract with Nickelodeon to star in a high school spin-off of Ned's Declassified School Survival Guide, unofficially called Ned's Declassified High School Survival Guide. According to TV Tropes, Werkheiser said that a pilot was shot, and Werkheiser himself cited on his blog that, quote-unquote, it's a work in progress, and we'll know in the next couple of months if it gets greenlit. Unfortunately, the show was never picked up by Nickelodeon, and it's stayed that way since. As the actors have since moved on from Nick onto bigger and better things, Daniel Curtis Lee, who played Cookie, may not have signed onto the contract, and if so, possibly because of his commitment to another show, Disney's Zeke and Luther.
I know some of you are going to be really disappointed about this, but Ned's Declassified High School Survival Guide didn't happen mostly because it didn't have the funds. You see, Ned's Declassified School Survival Guide didn't pull in the ratings as big as Drake and Josh and Zoe 101 at the time. During the mid-2000s, Dan Schneider was the king of live-action shows for Nickelodeon, and he kind of still is to this day. With that said, Nancy Classified was hugely overshadowed by Drake and Josh and Zoey 101, and when Nancy Classified was over, they didn't have the funds to produce a spin-off series.
Devin Wertheimer officially confirmed on a now privated YouTube video that there definitely won't be a continuation of the show, with budget issues at Nick being one of the main reasons. Johnny Bravo, Meso Blues. Meso Blues was the original thesis short for Johnny Bravo, created by Van Partebol in 1993. The short was about an Elvis Presley impersonator who would later become Johnny Bravo. Dan McLaughlin, who was Partebol's animation professor, showed the short to a friend working at Hanna-Barbera Productions, and the studio loved the short so much that they asked Partebol if he could do a 7-minute cartoon based on Meso Blues, but with a few changes. This would ultimately become the original Johnny Bravo show now. Despite its success in creating a beloved show, Meso Blues has never been released or even seen in public. Drake and Josh. Many fans would consider the first episode of Drake and Josh to be the pilot episode. However, there was a real official pilot for the show. This pilot was produced in 2003 and was made before Nickelodeon officially picked up the show. Not much is known about this, except that it supposedly used the same plot as the first episode, and Josh's dad was played by a different unknown actor instead of Jonathan Goldstein. The pilot remained in obscurity until 2013 when Dan Schneider posted screenshots on his Dan Warb Twitter account. Supposedly, he also posted a video clip on YouTube showing Josh's original dad, but that has since become privated and has not been mirrored anywhere else on the internet. Other than that, no other piece of info is available for this pilot and has yet to be released by Nickelodeon or by Dan Schneider himself. Arthur. The Great MacGrady and a few other episodes were banned from being aired because they featured a character similar to Lance Armstrong, who, at the time, was under controversy due to his doping incident. The episodes can still be found online. The Magic Adventures of Mumphie. When The Magic Adventures of Mumphie was released to Hulu, 17 episodes were missing. One of the missing episodes has been found in English. Six other missing episodes were released in English to VHS. By April of 2014, all but two of the missing episodes were uploaded in Norwegian to YouTube by the user Siremorder. Earlier in that same month, a Nico Nico Duga user uploaded a Japanese version of the first episode, which was later reposted to YouTube by the user Scarecrowella Sweetie, who then uploaded two more Japanese episodes. After Lionsgate went after some of her videos, they are now lost. The only traces of them are recordings of some cut scenes in a five-part video series called Mumphie Songs. Gravity Falls. Sometime in 2010, animator Alex Hirsch began working on a pitch pilot episode for Gravity Falls. The pilot ran for 11 minutes and was a cut-down version of the first official episode, Tourist Trapped. While not much background information of the pilot's creation has surfaced, besides the identities of those involved, a few screenshots and even a short 43-second snippet have managed to find their way online, along with a full outline of the episode, which is almost identical to that of Tourist Trapped. When asked if the unaired pilot would ever be released, Alex Hirsch replied with, "Oh Lord, I hope not. That thing was a mess, haha." That would be like showing you awkward photos from my high school prom. We all have dark secrets. That 11-minute flash pilot was mine. Regardless, fans hold on to the hope that it may one day be included as a DVD extra, or just flat out leaked online. Double Dare. Nickelodeon's most famous game show, Double Dare, is a show focused primarily on kids who have to go through usually disgusting obstacle courses in order to win prizes of trips and small amounts of money. Despite having many reruns for years, Several episodes are still unable to be seen online. In addition, there was at least one episode of Double Dare that was filmed but never aired. The episode involved a kid that had a condition that made his bones more fragile than the average contestant of the show. The kid lied about it on the application and made it onto the show. During filming of the episode, he broke his arm while doing one of the obstacles on the show. Nickelodeon, fearing being sued over the incident, especially since the kid's father was a lawyer, gave the kid a small prize as compensation, and the case was settled. The episode has never been seen, most likely because of this incident. Captain N, the Game Master. The episode How's Bayou was never finished when it first aired on NBC, due to time constraints. It was later replaced with a second, more common version on the Family Channel, with some dialogue replaced. Surprisingly, only the first version was released on DVD, and the second version is now considered lost. A 101 Dalmatians. An episode of 101 Dalmatians called Alive and Chicken was pulled from broadcast in the United States after 9/11 due to a scene where Spock crashes her airplane into a windmill. The episode is banned from being aired again, but can still be found on YouTube. The Powerpuff Girls. The pseudo-series finale, See Me, Feel Me, Know Me, was banned, allegedly due to being about communism. However, the actual reason was the heavy use of strobe effects, which would trigger epileptic seizures in more sensitive viewers. Much like the notorious Pokemon episode, Electric Soldier Porygon, the episode can still be seen on the complete series DVD set for the show. Cow and Chicken. The infamous second season episode Buffalo Gals was quickly pulled after its original broadcast, after a mother wrote into Cartoon Network, complaining about the lesbian stereotypes and sexual innuendo. Rocko's Modern Life. Rocko's Modern Life was infamous for having tons of adult jokes. Most of these jokes were either changed or removed in later versions of the episodes. Despite this, the show only had one banned episode, titled Leapfrogs. This episode was about Bev Bighead being ignored by her husband. So she tries to seduce Rocko while her husband's at work. The episode did see some airtime, at least twice, before Nickelodeon realized the mature content and demanded that it be removed. Buzz Lightyear of Star Command. The episode Supernova only aired twice before being removed from circulation in America. It's because it used superpowers caused by phasing through radiation as metaphor for drugs. It even showed signs of withdrawal. The episodes Conspiracy and Inside Job were also removed from being aired on Disney after 9/11 due to both episodes revolving around terrorist plots. Weirdos. This short-lived series, based off the 1960s Weirdos toys, only had 13 episodes, with 2 segments each episode. It also had 3 VHS releases, 1 DVD release, and 1 unaired pilot episode. In 2000, ADV released the whole series, except the unaired pilot, and 3 cassettes titled Lights, Camera, Traction, Wheel Trouble, and Traffic Jam. In 2005, YTV released the whole series onto DVD. All releases of the show are extremely rare to come by, and due to limited production, only 500 copies got sent into market, but only in Canada. Of the 26 segments in total, only 5 were found, one of which was found incomplete. Kablam. Kablam is one of Nickelodeon's most coveted shows, with no home media release of any kind, and only a few reruns. A handful of episodes are considered lost, most notably episode 29. Episode 29 is an episode many fans of the show have made their own art of, including fan fiction. This episode has even been considered fake for a long time. An internet archive website called the Wayback Machine enables you to visit most websites in the past. Fans have used this to get to the Nickelodeon website in the 90s to see Kablam's episode list. While only finding episode lists of seasons 1 to 3, it is clear that episode 29 is not on that list, but it's unknown if this confirms the episode's existence as fake, because the website is still unfinished. Supposedly, the episode was to be about Henry and June finally ending the comic book series, June revealing her crush by kissing Henry, and saying goodbye to the audience. All that. The popular Nickelodeon show has dealt with a lot of copyright issues that caused some segments or complete episodes to go missing or to be edited. Seasons 2-5 aired from 2011 to 2014, but they were all missing the musical performances, the sketches introducing the artists, and the original outros and credits. Luckily, the majority of seasons 3-5 aired on the N in 2008, and are available unedited online, with the exception of a few episodes that were never featured. Season 6 also aired, but the best of episodes that premiered during 2001 weren't broadcast. Season 1 hasn't been broadcast since 2005. All That's pilot episode is considered by many to be the most sought-after episode of the entire series. It hasn't aired on television for almost 2 decades. On September 23rd, 2014, the full episode was uploaded to a private tracker, only to be taken down shortly after. 1 day later, the entire pilot was uploaded to YouTube by the user GreenRift. Yuri the Spaceman. Yuri the Spaceman was a 2002 CGI animated series created by the Sparks Animation Studios and produced for Cartoon Network. The series consisted of 26 3-minute episodes about an astronaut named Yuri who's stranded on the moon. Not a lot of information on the series is available. It never received a home media release of any kind, eventually falling into obscurity. Oddly, it's not even given a single mention on the Sparks Animation Studios website. Of the 26 original episodes, only 2 of them have surfaced online. On February 2nd, 2015, 18 more episodes were uploaded to MySpleen and Dailymotion. The rest remain hidden. Merry Melodies. Looney Tunes and Merry Melodies had a group of 11 cartoons that were withheld from all syndication and network reruns since 1968 for heavy black stereotyping. The infamous ban list was dubbed the Censored 11, and none was more controversial than the 1943 short, Coal Black and the Seven Dwarves. The short was a parody of Snow White and the Seven Dwarves, featuring an all-black class with a jazz soundtrack. Despite being banned, the episode can still be found on Dailymotion. Postcards from Buster. Postcards from Buster was a spin-off from the TV show Arthur, starring Buster Baxter, Arthur's friend from the series. Some PBS affiliates refused to screen an episode titled Sugar Time, as it involved Buster visiting a child in Vermont with lesbian parents. The controversy surrounding the episode might have also compelled then-CEO of PBS, Pat Mitchell, to resign the following year. These episodes were aired periodically from 2006 to 2012, before the show was officially cancelled. The 15 episodes have completely vanished. Mickey Mouse Works. The controversial Mickey Mouse episode, Minnie Takes Care of Pluto, was shown only once in the US on January 22, 2000. The plot involves Minnie being forced to take care of Pluto, and Pluto being led to believe that Minnie is trying to kill him. The short received so many complaints that it was banned, never to be aired again in the US. The closest to an English dub available online is a recording of the episode, with polished audio and English subtitles. On October 9th, 2013, the English dubbed episode was recorded from a camcorder and uploaded to YouTube. Wienerville. Wienerville is a variety series slash puppet show that originally aired on Nickelodeon from July 11th, 1993 to February 17th, 1996. The series was a critical and commercial success, but ended after just two seasons. Due to the decrease in popularity and copyright issues with the cartoons that were featured, Nickelodeon hasn't broadcast any episodes since 1997, making episodes very hard to find. In 2008, 24 episodes appeared on a private torrent tracker and were eventually uploaded to YouTube. A few other episodes and specials made its way online before Mega Upload was taken down in 2011. Of the 62 episodes, 37 have yet to be found. The Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog. The episode, Mass Transit Trouble, was about a terrorist plot by Dr. Robotnik to destroy the Mobius transportation system with timed bombs placed in various locations. The episode was withdrawn from syndication following the Oklahoma City bombing incident and was never released on VHS. Eventually, Toon Disney picked up the episode and reran it for quite a while before being pulled again after 9/11 for the same reasons. For years, there was rumor circulating that the original pilot episode of the show existed somewhere. The halfway completed pilot episode featured character dialogue, but no sound effects and no music. While the original concept ended up becoming Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog and was placed in the syndication, the pilot itself was never finished. Nobody could manage to find the work print for years, until it eventually appeared on the internet, courtesy of lead animator Milton Knight, and was uploaded to YouTube.
Hooray! 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 I want that hedgehog!
Did someone say hedgehog? Got a race ace.
Get him!
Pingu. The episode, Little Accidents, was banned from airing in the US due to its blatant depiction of potty failure in many scenes. It was deemed impossible to edit without changing the whole plot. Another episode titled Pingu Quarrels with His Mom was also banned from America television due to a shocking scene where Pingu is slapped by his mother for insubordination. It was also banned from airing in countries where corporal punishment is a criminal offense. Finally, the episode Pingu and the Doll was banned in the US and Canada due to scenes where Pingu dresses up as a Native American and attempts to intimidate one. Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. In an episode titled Conflict, a potential war comes to the neighborhood when King Friday becomes convinced that a nuclear arsenal was secretly being built. The kids began building fallout shelters and wait for an all-out atomic war until King Friday realizes that he was wrong about what was being built. At the end of the episode, Mr. Rogers left viewers with the following summary. Rules are very, very important. Not just for games, but for all things. Even big things like countries. Countries have to have rules to protect people too. And someday you'll be helping to make rules for your country. I trust that you'll make the best kind you know how. This episode was first aired during the Cold War and hasn't aired since 1996. Since then, the full episode cannot be watched online. Ed, Edd, and Eddy. Luck Be an Edd Tonight and A Room and an Edd were two half episodes of the fifth season of Ed, Edd, and Eddy that were never made public and possibly never even made. The episodes were both announced through a season 5 sneak peek list posted on the Edtropolis news page in 2005. The episode, Luck Being Ed Tonight, was about Ed discovering that it's his lucky day, according to his horoscope, which resulted in Eddie trying to milk it for all it's worth. The second episode, A Room and an Ed, was about Sarah and Jimmy kicking Ed out of his room so that they can turn it into their own personal playroom. There isn't much else known about these episodes, including why they were scrapped and if they were even finished or not. More interestingly, was an episode that was never even finished called Special Ed. Very little is known about this episode, and the only evidence of its existence is from an interview with Danny Antonucci. He says the episode didn't go through because, quote unquote, it was just too real. Dexter's Laboratory. The infamous rude removal episode from Dexter's Laboratory was removed from Cartoon Network before it even aired. This was because the episode featured rude versions of Dexter and Dee Dee, who would swear in the episode, and Cartoon Network thought that was too inappropriate for kids. The episode's existence was questioned for quite some time by fans, since it was never aired to begin with. Adult Swim had tried to get the episode uploaded, and on January 22nd, Adult Swim sent out a tweet that simply stated, "With love, from Adult Swim," and contained a YouTube link to the episode. The video is now privated, but footage does exist online. A Dal M for Monkey segment titled Barricore featured a gay version of Marvel's The Silver Surfer called The Silver Spooner. The segment was believed to be banned for having a gay stereotype. However, the actual reason it was banned was because the creators of the Silver Surfer comics complained that their character was being used without permission. The Mr. Potato Head Show. The Mr. Potato Head Show was a children's television series featuring Mr. Potato Head. It first aired on Fox Kids on September 12, 1998. The series ran for a single season of 13 episodes before being canceled on February 16, 1999. After the series was canceled, the creators made a direct-to-video movie that depicts the show's cancellation from the perspective of the characters. Only the first four episodes can be watched online, but the rest of the series is nowhere to be found. Due to the show being incredibly obscure, there's very little chance of there being a home media release of any kind. Though bits and pieces of the missing episodes can be seen in the direct-to-video movie, the actual full episodes remain missing. Tiny Toons. The episode Elephant Issues contained three segments, one of which was called One Beer. This segment involves Buster, Plucky, and Hampton drinking alcohol, drunk driving a stolen car, and crashing to their deaths in a graveyard. The entire episode was banned from Fox Kids, Nickelodeon, Nicktoons, and the WB due to the depiction of Buster, Plucky, and Hampton getting drunk. Despite this, the episode was eventually included in the Volume 3 DVD set, and later aired in reruns on the Hub Network. Angry Beavers. In 2001, an episode segment titled Bye Bye Beavers was produced as the series finale for the show Angry Beavers. The segment caused controversy with Nickelodeon staff, resulting in the entire episode to never air. The plot involves the Beavers receiving mail alerting them that their show has been canceled. They go on to break the fourth wall, with the voice actors calling each other by their actual names, and criticizing Nickelodeon, stating that after the shows get canceled, they will continue to rerun without the creators being paid for. At the end of the episode, they both begin vanishing before yelling April Fools, implying that this episode was not intended to be the last. Nickelodeon did not like this episode too much, due to all the criticisms and a quote-unquote rule that they broke. Nickelodeon has a rule that states that no final episode of a show is allowed to allude to the fact that the show is ending. You're not allowed to make any hints about it, which Angry Beavers did. Because of this, the entire episode was never broadcast. Ren and Stimpy. Man's Best Friend was originally going to air in the second season, but the episode was banned by Nickelodeon for excessive violence and even tobacco references. According to Spike's official episode lineup on their website, the episode seemed to be considered as part of the Ren and Stimpy adult party cartoon. John K was hoping this would have been another one of his masterpieces for the season. He ended up being fired from Nickelodeon later on. Davy and Goliath. Several episodes of the Christian program Davy and Goliath were destroyed by the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America, the successor to the church that commissioned the series, due to material that today's mainline denominations would consider unfit for airing on children's program, such as racial stereotype and sexism. They were later found but re-edited and released on DVD. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles had an entire missing season. The missing season was called the Ninja Tribunal Arc and consisted of 13 episodes. 4Kids Entertainment signed a deal with Comcast, and this missing season began airing on Comcast On Demand in August 2006. However, after airing only 5 episodes, Comcast stopped airing the season altogether. The Ninja Tribunal episodes were scheduled to be released on DVD sometime in early 2007, but 4Kids removed them from the release schedule. Eventually, the season was promoted in commercials as Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles: The Lost Episodes. Another DVD set was released on May 20th, 2008. The episode, Nightmarish Recycled, was never completed. The script was finished and some animation had begun when 4Kids pulled the plug because it was deemed too controversial and violent for a children's program. Since there was no chance of it airing, it was shelved in the early stages of production and can no longer be seen. Pokemon. A number of Pokemon episodes have been under controversy from PETA, several churches, and just American censorship. Most infamously is the episode on December 16th, 1997, called Electric Soldier Porygon. About halfway through the episode, Pikachu electrocuted vaccine missiles, resulting in several explosions depicted by quick, bright, alternating flashes. This flashing caused an estimated 685 Japanese children to be hospitalized after suffering epileptic seizures, two of which remained hospitalized for up to 2 weeks. The event was so controversial that Pokemon was sent into a 4-month hiatus. The episode was immediately banned from re-airing worldwide, and the featured Pokemon Porygon was never mentioned in future episodes again. The Japanese episodes can be found online, whereas the English dub made for television was pulled before even airing. Sesame Street. Like Pokemon, Sesame Street has been in some trouble as well. Episode 847 featured Margaret Hamilton reprising her role as the Wicked Witch of the West as she flies over Sesame Street before accidentally losing her broom. The witch at first brings chaos to Sesame Street by threatening to turn Big Bird into a frying pan and making it rain inside Hooper's store. Eventually, the Wicked Witch grew to like Sesame Street, and they began to like her too. Oscar develops a crush on the witch, and Big Bird is saddened when she finds her broom and has to leave. This episode prompted an unusually large amount of male responses from parents, almost entirely negative within a short time frame. Typical responses included parents concerned that their children were afraid and now refused to watch the show, using phrases such as screams and tears, and the threat of the witch's power remains in the children's eyes. The episode has since been stored away and cannot be found online. The episode Snuffy's Parents Get a Divorce was pulled before airing after extremely negative reactions from a test screening. The episode attempted to deal with the issue of divorce, using Snuffy's parents as an example, but many children were confused. Some came away thinking that their parents wouldn't love them anymore. Some thought that their parents arguing meant that they were getting a divorce. It was decided that the concept was too full-on for children, and the episode instead became about Oscar the Grouch getting a visit from his brother. The episode Snuffy's Parents Get a Divorce, although fully complete, has never been shown or released to the public. The only evidence of the episode's existence is a few screenshots found in the 2009 book Sesame Street, A Celebration, 40 Years of Life on the Street. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like down below and subscribe to my channel.
If you're wondering what happened, so am I.